I'm honored to bring up our next speaker, and I guess I would say several speakers have mentioned being in Wayne's column, but the other thing that was really nice was if you were in Wayne and Mick's window. By that I mean if you had a house sign in Wayne's window, it really spoke volumes about how you were doing. And this past year, Wayne and Mick were very proud and had a sign in their window for an incoming state senator from the 11th district, now supervisor Senator Lex Scott Wiener.
It's so easy to forget those who came before you and to think it's just about you and doing the work that you're doing. And I think we all constantly need to remind ourselves, and I know I'm constantly wearing this under Leno and Professor Campos and Jose, and all of us remember that we stand on the shoulders of giants. We are those of us who have the honor of being in leadership in the community. We are here only because the Wayne Fridays of the world fought for decades and decades when it was not as easy as it is today to make sure that our community was out of the shadows, was at the table, and we owe Wayne and the other Wayne Fridays of the world an unbelievable debt of gratitude for really building the modern LGBT community. I came to San Francisco and got involved in 1997 when I was 27 years old with the LGBT Community Center, and Mark Leno took me under his wing right before he got appointed to the Board of Supervisors. And I'm very fortunate to have met and been mentored by a few different people who were in Harvey Milk's inner circle. By my first consultant, Jim Rivaldo, who I know helped get a bunch of people in this room elected, and Dick Pavish, also Aaron Cronenberg, and Dan Nicoletta, but also Wayne. And when I first decided to run for office, I had met Wayne before, but Dennis Herrera said, you gotta sit down with Wayne. This is almost a decade ago. And I sat down with him, and he said a few things. I think the first thing he said is, why the hell do you want to do that? In that very Wayne kind of way. The second thing was, never stop being a human being. This is someone who had seen so many elected officials come and go, and there was no one who I think had a better antenna for what it took to be a successful leader, a successful elected official. Wayne is also someone who he worshipped Senator Feinstein, Dennis, and Carol, and Gavin, and all of our great non-LGBT elected officials. But he is someone who, in his heart, understood and really proselytized about the importance of electing LGBT people to office. And the fact that Supervisor Campos and I don't always agree on everything, but Wayne was there for both of us because it was that important to him to make sure that we have our allies and also our own seat at the table, and it was one of his core values. And I will be eternally grateful to this amazing human being for everything he's done for the community, for so many people that I care about. It was hard at the end to see Wayne physically decline. And I know there are a number of people in this room who went and visited with him and were there with him for many, 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 many days and hours. But as much pain as he was in and as great as his struggles were, that personality never went away. He was in the hospital, couldn't even sit up straight, and he was still cracking jokes, and he was still telling you what you were doing right and what you were doing wrong. I mean, old Wayne just was always there. And so I just want to thank everyone who was with him during that final phase and helped remind him how much support he had in the circle of friends and in the community. So thank you.